Let's have a look at these relationships, beginning with associations. Associations are denoted by solid lines connecting two class rectangles. Here's an example of a UML class diagram containing two relationships and three classes. We have the polygon class, the point class, and a graphics bundle class. Between polygon and point, we have an association called contains. That is, a polygon contains points. The little filled triangle to the right of the word contains means that when reading aloud that particular relationship, you would read from left to right. So polygon contains point. You wouldn't say point contains polygon. You would say something like point is contained by polygon. The second association at the bottom between graphics bundle and polygon isn't named directly. This is fine. We'll see that we can describe it using roles, which are ways of saying, giving similar information about how the association is relating the two classes. There's lots of possible notational affordances for associations. You can have a name, as in contains. You can have association classes. They weren't shown in this diagram, but we'll look at them a little bit later. And you can have aggregation and composition. In the example, we saw both of these. The open diamond indicated aggregation, and the closed, that is the filled diamond, indicated composition. In both cases, we are saying that the two classes are related by some kind of containment relationship. That is, a polygon is made up of points. We saw reading direction, that was the filled triangle. We can also express navigability, which is the appearance of an arrowhead on one end of, or both ends of, the association line. This indicates that the primary access pattern for those classes is in the direction of the arrow. That is, we're going to be going normally from polygons to their points and not in the other direction. You can express multiplicity. In the diagram, we saw star, we saw three dot dot star. Star means any number of instances. Three dot dot star means between three and any number of instances. We also saw a property ordered, which indicates that, at least for the case of the polygon and its points, those points are in a particular order. They might be, for example, in clockwise order. Not shown in the example diagram is the ability in UML class model diagrams to express associations which involve more than two classes. In our text browser example, there were three classes involved, and we use a rhombus into which the various lines come in to indicate all the participants within that particular association. We saw also the fact that you could have role names. The word bundle, adjacent to the graphics bundle class, indicates the graphics bundle is playing the role of bundle in that particular association. You can have these role names on either or both ends of the association line, or you don't need to have them at all. Also not shown are the fact that you can express qualification. You can think of qualification as indicating what are the keys into the set of instances. We'll see an example of that in a minute. And you can express also certain constraints on the association. For example, that they're ordered, that they're frozen, that is, the association can't change, that you can only add things to it, and so on.